Now let's flesh out our search box. And I'm going to start with the HTML. So here's our search box. And we're just going to go ahead and add the text. Type a URL here. And then we'll have an input type equal text ID URLbox. And then for our go button, we're just going to have a span and we're going to put an ID on it, go button, so that we can style it. And then the text go and end our span. So you'll notice this isn't a real form, but we don't need it to be a real form because we're going to add JavaScript event handlers. And then let's go ahead and reload, make sure it's showing up so far. Good. And then we're going to style it. So let's go to our CSS. And we want a black box all the way across the top. And so the first thing we want to do is get rid of the margin on the body. So let me go at the top and I'm going to set margin to 0 pixels for the body. And then I'm going to go ahead and style the search box. So let's set the background to black and the text color to white. And we'll make it 100% wide. And we'll center the content and also vertical align all the elements to middle. And then let's put some padding on there, 10 pixels. And let's take a look. Did I call it search box? Yeah, search box. It may be a cache issue. So let's go F12, network. Cache is disabled. Let me hit reload. So it loaded fetchpage.css. And we have all of our stuff in there. Oh, now it's showing up. Okay, well, good. So we have the text and the box. And now let's style the button so it looks like a button. So that's the go button. And let's set the background here to be red. And the text color to black so it contrasts with the white text in the box. And we'll add some padding so it's about the right size. And then let's style the font a little bit. So we'll use bold text. And I should specify fallback fonts, but that's probably fine for now. And font size, so a little smaller than the rest of the text. And then we're also going to vertically align the text and the button. And then when the arrow is over it, we want the cursor to be a pointer. So let's reload. Good. Okay, so that looks reasonable. And you get a little pointer. So this is not wide enough to type a URL into, so let's make it take up half of the available space. So that's the URL box. Start with 50%. Great. And so that looks pretty good. It's a little wider than the screen. Okay, that looks fine. So now we have to make it actually do something. So let's go to our JavaScript. And we want to put two event handlers here. So we want to click event handler that when you click on it, it submits whatever's in the box. And also, if you type something into the box, like, and then hit return, we want to run the same submit function. So what we're going to do is I'm going to have a function called add event listeners that's going to attach those event listeners. And I'm going to have a function submit, which is going to take the text contents and direct back to fetch page with that URL. And then add event listeners. So the first thing we want is straightforward. That's going to be the click handler for this button. And that's the go button. So we want to say document.get element by ID go button. Add event listener. Click is going to call submit. And then handling a carriage return in the type in box, that's going to be an event handler on the URL box. And we're going to be looking at key down events. So every time the user presses a key, we're going to get that event and we're going to check to see whether the key that they pressed was a carriage return. So that's going to be document.get element by ID URL box, add event listener, key down, and then there's going to be a function here. So one of the parameters that gets, or one of the arguments that gets passed to this function when the event goes off is an event object that has information about the event. And we haven't been using it so far, but we'll need it here because it has the key code for the character that the user typed. So if event.keycode is equal 13, that's a carriage return, or I'll also listen for line feeds. So if either of those things is true, then we're also going to call submit. So that matches that, closes off the event listener. That should be fine. Okay, so for submit, right now I'm going to just console.log submitted. Encode URI component document get element by ID URL box dot value. So let's reload and view the console. And I'm going to copy and paste that URL and then hit return. So let me go to the console here and hit return. Okay, so no error. Am I calling add event listeners? Yes. Let's click go. Nothing there either. So let's see if we're actually getting to here when we load. So fetchpage.js. And I don't have my code. So I saved it. Let's Reload again. Now I have it. So it's just a little slow. Paste, return. And let's look at the console. So submitted encoded URI, and then go does the same thing. Good, so that's working. So now, the way that I actually cause this thing to run, like submitting, is I change the window location. So window.location.href equals window.location.origin plus window.location.pathname plus question URL equals plus encode URI component, that whole thing. And that should be it. So let's go ahead and try it out. We'll grab the URL, paste it in. So this should take me to chapter 13. And it does. So I can type other things, which won't work. That actually looks pretty good, but script won't work. And also I'm covered by this bar at the top. So this is absolutely positioned, and so it's covering up my bar because my layout doesn't work. And of course the search doesn't work at all, so that's broken. Or let's try Mozilla Developer Network. That's a good one to check out. Developer.mozilla. Is it org or net? Yep, that's it. So, got some content. But you'll notice none of the scripts work here. And we can actually make some of them work. So I'm going to go ahead and in the next video, I'll make some of these scripts work that don't currently. But I can actually browse. So there's HTML basics. It's not terrible.